Hello everybody, my name is Matteo and I'm an official tour guide of the city of Rome. On behalf of New Rome Free Tour, partner of Free Tours by Foot, I welcome you to Piazza Navona, one of the most beautiful squares of Rome. As you can see, this square has a very peculiar shape. It's not, as we are used to think, square or rectangular, but it's oval and reminds a stadium. There is a reason for that. Piazza Navona has a double name, Piazza Navona or Stadio di Domiziano, Domitian Stadium. How came that this square is named after a Roman stadium? We are going to discover it. 10 meters under the level of the modern Piazza Navona, there is still the old stadium built by the Emperor Domitian in the year 85 after Christ. It was a stadium of around 30,000 seats, 265 meters long, where the old Romans used to organize athletic competitions like running, boxing and fighting. This is the reason why the name of the medieval square was In Agone, that means through the games, as in this stadium they used to organize games for the entertainment of the emperor and the Roman people. The Stadium of Domitian is the first example of masonry stadium for athletism ever built in ancient Rome, and it's a unique example of history of sport and Roman architecture. It has been rediscovered at the beginning of the 20th century during the excavations for the construction of the modern road, and from here it's still perfectly visible the old and original entrance of the stadium. On this map, we can see where we are today in the modern city center of Rome and where we would have been at the ancient Roman times. We are going to take a look a bit closer to the old stadium of Domitian. With us, all doors would be open. From here, we have a perfect view of the old entrance of the stadium through the opposite side, the ones we saw before. Seeing everything in Rome in 2 days, it's impossible. But it's easy to understand this city in only two words. Rome is a city of marble and water. And the city of marble and water can be perfectly explained, perfectly synthesized by what we see here in Piazza Navona. If Renaissance was born in Florence, Baroque art was born here in Rome. Baroque literally means complicated, difficult, but the real meaning of the word Baroque here in Rome is wow. Wow, fantastic, because this was the goal that the greatest Baroque architects of the world wanted to achieve when they made their masterpieces. Here in Piazza Navona, we are very lucky as we have two great Baroque architects, Gian Lorenzo Bernini and Francesco Borromini, rival competitors living in the same period, working in the same areas. Gian Lorenzo Bernini did, here in this beautiful square, on order of Pope Innocent X, between 1648 and 1652, the three fountains that today decorate the square. Among them, for sure, the most important and beautiful is the one we see here in the center, the Fountain of the Four Rivers. It was made in marble and travertine and decorated with an obelisk that used to be in the Circus of Maxentius along the ancient Appian Way, in order to demonstrate the strength and the intelligence of the old Roman architects compared with the genius of the Baroque, Gian Lorenzo Bernini. The fountain is named after the four rivers, represented and personified by the four gentlemen, the four giants that decorate the basement of the fountain. They represent at the same time the four longest rivers in the world, but also the four continents, Americas, Asia, Africa, and Europe, Of course, there isn't Australia that at that time hadn't been discovered yet. The four rivers are the Ganges, the Rio de la Plata, the Nile, and the Danube, and they are represented in four different positions, one of them with a terrified expression facing the Church of Saint Agnes, made by the rival and competitor of Bernini, Francesco Borromini. Bernini and Borromini, the architects who designed this square, didn't like each other. They were rivals, they were competitors, and the legend says that here in Piazza Navona, there are still symbols that talk about the competition between these two geniuses of Baroque art. For example, the river that you see here behind us has a terrified expression, and it's protecting itself with the hands by something that's going to fall down. What is that? The Church of Saint Agnes, built by Francesco Borromini. Bernini wanted to mean that the church wasn't well built, it was going to collapse, to crack, and to destroy the fountain it just built. When Borromini saw this trick, of course, he didn't accept the joke and he wanted to answer somehow. And that's why, despite Baroque art, it's full of statues, he decided to decorate the facade of the church with one single statue, right here on top, nearby the bell. And as you can see, the statue is not looking at the fountain, it's looking at us with the hand of the heart to mean, don't worry, my friend, this church is very well built and solid. It's not going to collapse, it's not going to destroy anything. You know what, my friends? Whatever I told you is a fake. It's the first example of fake news, yes, because the fountain was accomplished in 1652 and the church was started after 1652. So basically, Borromini and Bernini never fought about the fountain and the church. But what about the rivalry? It's completely true. Piazza Navona is not only architecture, but it's also art and tradition. Since the 50s, artists and painters coming from all over the world came here to Rome, in the heart of the city, in Piazza Navona, making this place becoming the Italian Montmartre. Real painters that can make both views of the city of Rome, but also portraits of tourists and visitors who come visiting Rome during their holidays. Like Igor, here behind me. Here, since over 20 years ago, he spends time in the square, inspired by what he sees around him, decorating with oil and watercolors the canvas with the views of the city of Rome. Another tradition that can be seen nearby Piazza Navona is the Roman tradition of the Tolkien statues. In the past, until modern times, in Rome was forbidden to express his opinion about politics or about common life in the city. That's why there were six statues, and Pasquino, the one behind my shoulders, is the most important among them, where people was allowed to write messages complaining about the Pope, about the cardinals, and in modern times, about politicians. In the beginning, the messages used to be written directly at the bottom of the statue. That's the statue of Ajaces sustaining the body of Patroclo, one of the statues that used to decorate the stadium of Domitian. But today, we upgrade to this modern plastic box where people still write his messages and his opinion about modern Italian politicians. We are going to show you the best place to drink something here in Rome, to have a drink, to eat something. Nothing's better than Piazza del Fico. It literally means the square of the fig tree. Guess why? So guys, thank you for having been with us. We hope you enjoyed this short walk around the city center of Rome and the beautiful Piazza Navona. Thanks again for having been with us, and see you soon here in Rome. Arrivederci.